By the early 1900s, the American public was experiencing vast problems with their food, drug, and biologics marketplaces. Journalists and activists began exposing things like watered-down and embalmed milk. For example, the popular preservative formaldehyde caused severe illness and even death. Some scientists dedicated themselves to addressing these issues. Dr. Harvey Washington Wiley, chief chemist at the U.S. Department of Agriculture, showed the danger of chemicals such as borax, a common household detergent, when used to preserve food. This was a national problem that needed a federal solution.
The chemist came out swinging hard at the food industry, calling for greater regulation of chemicals in food for the protection of the American public.
On July 1, 1902, Theodore Roosevelt signed the Biologics Control Act, which required the licensure of biological products and manufacturing establishments. Then, 4 years later, Congress passed the Pure Food and Drugs Act of 1906. The law banned the adulteration and misbranding of food and drugs and established the consumer protection agency we know today as the FDA.
Labeling is governed by the Federal Food, Drug, and Cosmetic Act and the Fair Packaging and Labeling Act. These laws stipulate that the label must tell the truth about the product.
The 20th century came with rapid advances in science and technology. The law had to pivot quickly, and the FDA with it. In 1938, Congress gave FDA the power to regulate cosmetic products, which had quickly gained popularity, including the eyebrow and eyelash dye, Lashler, which blinded and reportedly killed some users. The 1970s brought considerable strengthened requirements to ensure safe and effective medical devices. A wide range of FDA-approved medical devices, from intrauterine devices to pacemakers, keep the American public safe and healthy today. Additionally, in 1972, responsibility for the regulation of biologics, including blood and vaccines, was transferred to the FDA. Cutting-edge science has continuously improved product regulation and assisted the FDA in pursuing enforcement over countless problematic products.
Defects in plastic medical devices can occur at various stages of manufacture. For this reason, strict quality assurance procedures must be followed during the entire process.
More recently, the FDA has adapted to combat one of the biggest health crises of the 20th century, tobacco-related illnesses and death. Concerned with youth-oriented marketing and decades of evidence of health risks, the agency attempted to regulate cigarettes in the 1990s. The U.S. Supreme Court rejected the FDA's assertion of authority in this area, but Congress would eventually pass the 2009 Family Smoking Prevention and Tobacco Control Act, explicitly providing the FDA authority in this area.
I also know that kids today don't just start smoking for no reason. They're aggressively targeted as customers by the tobacco industry. They're exposed to a constant and insidious barrage of advertising where they live, where they learn, and where they play.
Today, the Center for Tobacco Products not only regulates, but educates the public on the dangers of tobacco products. In addition to addressing tobacco use, the FDA has also spent considerable time on many other public health priorities, such as recalls of foods contaminated with pathogens like salmonella, and helping to facilitate the availability of safe and effective vaccines for prevention of infectious diseases, including COVID-19 and influenza. As long as the FDA exists, we will continue to evolve as needed to protect and promote public health. To learn more about FDA history, check out the videos on our YouTube channel or visit fda.gov/history.